We are ready for our last art explorers lesson in our winter season. And as always, we love to go through those four art explorer rules, which you should know by heart by now. Oh, let's see. Will, go ahead. What do you got?
Don't judge your art.
Yes, don't judge your art is the same thing as there is no right or wrong way to be an artist. We are all artists. As long as you make art, you are considered an artist. You're right about that. Very well done. Ah, here comes Annabella now. Molly Jo, your hand is so nice and high. What would you like to share with us?
Do your best and forget the rest.
Yeah, that's a great one. I'm glad that you remember that, right? Because we're not supposed to be sweating it, right? We're just supposed to be doing our best. And then after that, you just got to let it go, right? No stressing out about it. That's perfect. Perfect, perfect. There we go. And here comes Emma right now. Thank you so much for closing those curtains. How about the other one, Annabella? Any chance you can take care of that? Awesome. Then I can see your beautiful smile. Good, good, good. Good. Hi, Emma. How are you?
Hi, I'm good.
Good, good. We just started. We've done two rules. There's no right or wrong way to be an artist, and do your best and forget the rest. So your timing is perfect, so you can share your favorite one.
Notice and observe.
Thank you so much for that. Notice and observe. Yeah, we got a real fun one today. So I think you're gonna be able to notice some good things about this little critter. And Annabella, what would you like to share?
The other day I painted this squishy.
You painted that? How fun is that?
I painted the color on it, like the cherry red and the frosting and the chocolate.
Oh, how fun. It looks realistic. It looks delicious. I want to eat it.
I painted on it.
Yum. Yum. I'm going to bite right into that chocolate cake with the whipped cream and the strawberry. Awesome. Okay, so our last one is how to have fun, but I got to make sure that you're really going to tell me that you're willing to have some fun here. So on that count of three, let me hear it. One, two, three.
Have fun.
I didn't hear everybody. Let's try that again.
Have fun.
Okay. Those that are willing to participate. Thank you so much for that. Okay, let's do our little screen share here. Everyone got a good view?
Yep.
Good.
The Art Explorers.
Art Explorers. Our last lesson of In the Woodlands. Let me fix my monitor here so I can see most people. Great. And today we are talking about hedgehogs. Hedgehogs. Everyone know what a hedgehog is? Yeah? Lucy, are you there? I don't see your monitor. Yes, she is. Good. Everyone know one? I have never seen a hedgehog in person, I'll be the first to admit, mostly because hedgehogs are found in the United Kingdom. Anyone know what countries are in the United Kingdom?
Nope.
That's England and Ireland, Scotland, in the continent of Europe. So you don't see them here in the United States. You probably may not be familiar with them. There are over 15 different species of hedgehogs. Here's a cute little one that's mostly dark colored, dark brown and black. He reminds me of a teddy bear. And there, you can see how small they are by how they fit in the palm of your hand. Molly Jo, could you please stop that? Thank you so much. We want to have some good listening ears on. So they're tiny, they're smaller than your hand. Here's a good guy. We're going to draw our hedgehog facing sideways. So it's a good thing that we have this nice profile on the hedgehog. The hedgehog's best senses are their ears. And so their ears are kind of big in relationship to this little critter. And their nose is extra long because they got a wonderful nose for smelling. Their eyes, not so good. They use the nose and the ears mostly for hunting. They are nocturnal. Who knows what nocturnal means? Emma, what's nocturnal?
It's like an animal that sleeps in daytime and awake at night.
Excellent. Excellent. Yeah. So of all the animals we did this winter season, anyone can remember another nocturnal animal that we covered? Go ahead, Luce. What do you think?
Owl?
The owl. Exactly. The owl is a night hunter. Yeah. Was there something else? What else, Emma?
A bat?
A bat is, yes. We didn't actually draw the bat this time, but yes, a bat would be a night hunter. You're right. You're right about that. So just so you know the difference, there is a difference between a hedgehog and a porcupine. Porcupine is a much larger animal, tends to be about 12 inches long, and he's got these hecka long needles on him. They are called quills when the needles are on a porcupine. They're just called regular needles on a hedgehog. Anyone know the purpose of these spikes? What the adaptation is, why these animals have them? Will, what do you think?
It's for defense. So like if an animal tries to attack it, I think they like use them and they're very sharp and then they hit the other animal.
That's right. Usually an animal will try to touch them. It's not like they fire them out like firing squad. Usually you touch it and then the quills or the needles would get on them. But yes, you're absolutely right. They are meant for protection. So let's look at a couple more illustrations of hedgehogs. These are kind of what we're going to be going for. The hedgehog is going to have this nice little slope in his forehead leading to that little ball nose and then coming out. And you can see how the ears are kind of like these double C's, these double rainbows inside each other with a little tiny smile on them. So these are good examples of what we're going to be going for. And of course, the needles are coming along his body. There are between 2,000 and 5,000 of these needles on a hedgehog. You will not need to draw that many, I promise, because that is a lot of needles. Let's just look at a couple others. Super duper cute. There we go. Little hedgies. Little hedgies. And another example done by two different illustrators or drawers. I love this set in particular because he's just so sweet. All right, on this set, which one do you like the best? Who wants to volunteer which ones they like the best? Will, which one do you like the version of?
I like 10 because it's kind of, it's not, I wouldn't say realistic, but they don't do like all of it. They just do like some of it to give you like a picture of it.
Yeah.
What it would kind of be like.
So they come in from different angles. Is there a certain angle you like the best of this one hedgehog?
I really like the one standing up or the one sleeping.
Oh,
or the one with his like mouth open, like ooh.
Oh yeah, he's got definitely got an expression on there, huh? Yeah. How about you, Molly?
I think it was the one underneath the one standing.
Oh, this guy. Yeah, he's the. Yeah. This is the kind of, well, ours are gonna be on hind legs, so I think maybe this might be the closest. I'll show you ours in just a second. So Molly Jo, on this screen, is there one that you like better than another?
Sorry, I like the one that's next to the jumping one on the right.
This guy here?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, let's look at a couple others. Of course, hedgehogs can have the fantasy element to them. So here's three different illustrations with the artist's interpretation of what they wanted to do. One with headphones, kind of chilling out with his iPod. Some with sunglasses and... Who's ever heard of a rainbow hedgehog? Not me. And they can get super silly. Hedgehogs in trees. Annabella, you doing okay?
Yeah.
Great. For this little critter, I love that they've actually included the hedgehog with the mushroom, just like we had done, that red-capped mushroom. Here's some more realistic looking hedgehogs. These are done in watercolor paints. This one is generated by a computer. So this would be something like Illustrator software. And this is the shape, the general shape we're going for today. We're going to start with like a big gigantic letter C, I would call it, but almost like the fur part is, what would you call that? Like a squash, something like that. And notice how his face and belly is a lighter color. We are just going to leave it white. We are not even going to paint that guy. Emma, you moving? You're okay?
Yeah, sorry.
Okay, no problem. So this guy on the left was actually created by the same illustrator who did all those illustrations we did for the last 2 weeks of the owl and the fish and the rabbit. His name was graphic designer Celestino Piatti. And this is my little version of the guy over here. And you can see how we're gonna do like the little points. We're not gonna do thousands and thousands of points, I promise. This is our project. So we're gonna have little Hedgie holding a flower. And I wanted you to look at some real flowers and the name of the flower. The flower is called the Black-Eyed Susan. They call it black eye because the center is kind of brownish black. So it's the black center. You could think of it that way. Lucy, you still with us? Because I'm missing your monitor.
What? Wait.
Okay, we're good now. We're all good.
I have a question.
Yeah, I'm taking questions. What you got?
When we, like, there's no feet on number 18, that hedgehog, there's no feet on it.
Don't worry about it. Because
it's are we going to put feet?
His feet are so tiny that you can barely see them.
Really?
Yeah. So we can put him in if you want. You could. Here he is in a profile.
Oh, yeah. Those are really tiny.
You can see him here. And then let's go back to the real one. It's a good question. Look at this guy. You can't even see his feet.
You can see that one's feet.
And this one you can see. So if you feel like it's strange without the feet, you can put him in. But I don't think you need him. Like that guy, you can't see his feet. So it just depends. But so I'll let you put him in if it bothers you. Look at this guy. No feet. So that's why I put no feet. But if you want them, you can. Okay. We're going to move on to the flower, okay? Our black-eyed Susan. So the black-eyed Susan has that center button. Some people call it an eye. To me, it looks like a 3D button. And notice how it's created with like a big rainbow on the top, an arc, and then just softer on the bottom. And the petals come out just like a daisy. We call that radiating. They come out from the center and go out just like the rays of the sun. They come out from the middle. And many black-eyed Susans have two levels or two layers of petals. And that's what we're gonna go for today. So I want you to pay special attention. Everyone got their eyes up? I want you to look to see how the petals are, some petals are tucked underneath. Like we got this big one right here, this fat one, but then we got some that are on the side and many that are tucked in. Also notice how it has like these striations, these bands coming out. They just help give it a little bit more 3D look. Maybe it looks a little bit more curvy, but they'll definitely be tucked underneath each other. And I'll show you the steps to kind of create that overlapping style. I see Emma's looking at getting some paper. Yep, we're doing watercolor paper today, the extra heavy short one. That's the one, yep. And I want you to also look at the leaves. We're just gonna put one leaf on. It is fairly large and kind of roughly. You can see how it breaks in certain places. It's not a smooth leaf. In fact, if I were to zoom in on this, you would see little tiny hairs on the leaf and on the stem.
I have a question.
I love questions. What you got?
Oh, wow. Those are pretty. Sorry. You said in the beginning that we're not going to be painting it, and then you showed us our project that we're going to do, and then you painted it. So are we going to paint it or not?
Did I say we weren't going to paint? The process that we're going to do is we're going to draw it in pencil, go over all the lines in Sharpie, and then we're gonna paint it. So we are painting today.
Yeah, I don't know, but maybe I misheard you. I think I don't really know, but I may have thought you said that we were not painting it.
Well, I'm glad you got clarification on that. Yep. So that's why we're going to have to get busy, because we're doing painting, drawing, and Sharpie. So here, I just want to show you again, this little button. It's a black and white on purpose. And see how it's got like these little bumpy shapes on top? So the button is not an exact arc. It has little bumps on it. And the petals come from the bottom and they tend to bend down a little bit. So that is our black-eyed Susan. Before we start drawing and then painting, anyone want to share, since we're going to watch our time, just their one favorite one. Okay, Lucy, go for it.
My favorite one is on page on number 10.
And which one?
That one at the bottom. It's so cute.
He is cute, isn't he? And that's pretty much how we're going to do our face. Notice how that little slope, that slope in his forehead to his nose, the button nose and smile and the ears. Notice how the ear comes right at the hairline or the spike line. That's pretty much what we're going for. So I'm glad you like that one. Anybody else? Emma, yeah.
I like the second one.
The second photograph?
Yeah.
This one? Yeah. What do you like about him?
I like that he's just really cute.
He is cute. It kind of makes me giggle. Yeah. Yeah. Interesting how these little spikes, they're white at the very, very tip, and then the bases are dark. We won't have to do that because that's way too complicated. Yeah. Anybody else want to share? Nobody else wants to share? All right. Then we are going to get cracking. Before we do, I just want to remind you of our spring session that's going to start after spring break. Will, you want to say something?
About where it says spring session.
Uh-huh.
Can you go to that page?
Yeah.
I really like this sloth and I want to do that.
Good, because we're going to do the sloth. In fact,
The llama.
I could show you some of the samples. There's the llama all ready to go. Here's Mr. Sloth. He is just super cute. So cute. Yeah. It's going to be fun. Looking forward to that. Before we start drawing, I always like to take a poll. Where are you? Ooh, did I erase it? I think I did. Oh, here it is. I'd like to know what you guys liked about this session, what your favorite project was and why. And I would like to hear from everyone. I saw Emma's hand first. Emma, which one did you like and why?
So I really liked the one with like the trees and like the.
You like that one? And what is it you liked about that one?
I really liked how it's like 3D, and I also like the shadows.
Yeah. I like the perspective is what we call that 3D sense of coming from the top and looking down. And very unique. Not too many people draw art like that, right? So that one's a really unique project. I'm glad you like that one. Molly Jo, what would you like to share?
Like the mushroom.
The mushroom? What is it you liked about the mushroom?
I like that we actually use like pom-poms for it and that we use a lot of gluing for it.
Yeah, it was kind of fun. It's different to do something when it has some 3D objects on it, huh? I agree. Will, how about you? What was your favorite?
My favorite was probably the bear.
Uh-huh. And what did you like?
I like the bear.
Uh-huh.
And the reason why I liked it is, it was kind of, or actually, I think I like the owl, the rabbit, and the fish.
Uh-huh. Because
it's all one thing. It's all like three things in one piece of paper.
Yep, we would call that a composition when you have multiple items on one piece of paper. So you like the composition of this one. I know you did a really good job with that owl. You were very proud of your owl. So that was an awesome one for you. Yeah. How about you, Annabella?
I like the bird one.
The bird one? And what is it you liked about the bird?
I don't know. I just like it a lot. Yeah. I like the branch.
Oh, yeah. Hopefully you learned something, right? That's how Mother Nature works, that branches come and come in the Y shape. So now you guys are like experts at drawing branches. You can draw your own Y-shaped branches. Nice. And Lucy, your turn.
I really like the bear. The bear was one of my favorites. And then honestly, I like all of them that I did. It was actually super duper duper fun. Like, because I couldn't choose. I was like, oh wait, should I do the bear, the mushroom, the bird, the owl, the bunny, the fish, or the trees above? And I was like, I can't pick.
You can't decide. But that's a teacher's best thing they could ever hear. You love all the projects. It means I'm right on. Good. Hopefully you're going to like that hedgehog project we're going to do today too. Yep. And Sammy, do you have a favorite? Samantha?
My favorite one was the bear.
The bear? Is there anything in particular you liked about it?
I liked how you could choose like soft colors or warm colors or dark colors.
Nice. Your mom sent me the pictures of the three creatures together. Your fish is totally rocking it. Just letting you know. Outstanding job with that fish. Looked really good. Really, really good. All right. Thanks for your input. Did I get everybody? I don't have everybody on screen. So hopefully I got everyone. Did I miss anyone? Nope. Okay. Cool. Let's stop the sharing and get some drawing going. So as we know, we're doing the hedgehog and he's going to be facing profile, right? Only one side of profile. Let me get you the sample. There he is. So we're going to put the very first mark we're going to do is going to be like a gigantic letter C. But before we begin, things I want you to notice, just the placement of the elements on the composition. So that hedgehog is pretty darn big. We're going to put it in the horizontal sideways position. Lucy, could you please listen? Thank you. We're going to put it in a sideways position. And the hedgehog is big, so it's going to cover one half. And the flower is big, it's going to cover the second. And notice how the little hedgehog has his hand gripping around the stalk of the stem. So we're going to need to have the stem kind of curvy. So that, and the flower is heavy, so that's bending it down a little bit. Oh, before we begin, does everyone have the watercolor paper, the thickest paper?
What does it say on it?
I think it says
watercolor
or something. Not the one that says March 24, 25, because that's just regular construction paper. It's the one, I think it says extra watercolor, if I remember correctly.
Emma,
what does it say? Watercolor extra. Yep, that's what it says. That's the one.
I have three small papers. So this one says March 24/25.
Not that one, because that's just regular.
That's probably the one we're going to use.
Not that one. I switched to
March 3/4.
I don't know what that one was. Is it?
And then this is watercolor.
Watercolor. If you see the word watercolor.
This one's the
thickest one.
This one's the thickest?
Perfect.
Oh, wait.
Perfect. Thickest. Okay. And if it says watercolor on it, you're on the right one. Awesome. Anyone else have a question? Will, did you have a question? Yeah, go for it.
I only have one that says February 10th / 11 and March 24th, 25.
Probably what happened when February came, you used the wrong piece of paper. That's my guess. Is it thick?
Both of these are kind of thin.
Okay, you use the February one because I know it's definitely not the March 24th, 25. Okay, Annabella, you're good? Okay, Sammy, you're all right? Cool. Alrighty. Let's get started. Very first mark is a gigantic letter C. Just a little fingertip on the bottom. You want a little bit of space, especially if you want to frame it. And then about half finger on the top. Yes, Sammy?
Kind of like a C.
Yes, excellent. Thank you. Molly Jo, you can make yours a little bigger. It's a little tiny, especially on the bottom. Have that curve come down a little bit more. Okay. Everyone has a good eraser, I hope. Yes, Will.
I'm leaving right now.
Okay. Well, don't even start. I'm just going to send you the whole video and you can do it on the video. Okay?
Yeah.
Good luck on your baseball game.
And I think how you get the video is you press record, right?
Yep. You see in the upper left, it says recording. Yep, we're recording right now. You got it. Yep. All right. And I'll see you for the spring session too. Your mom signed you up for that. Yeah. I'm happy to hear that.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Take care. Awesome.
Is this good? Wait, let me. Sorry.
Yes. I'm just creating a little space for me. My desk is a little crowded. Let me just work on that. Okay, I'm taking a peek at some. Emma, looking good. Annabella, twice the size. Twice the size of what you got. In relationship to the paper, it's a big hedgehog. Nice, Molly Jo. If you want it, Molly, you can give us a little bit more space here. It's a little crowded on the edge. I'm taking a look. You're on the right track, Lucy. Just go ahead and continue your curve down on the bottom. Sammy, how you looking? Can any chance you can move your monitor down so I can see more than just the top of your head? Thank you. Yeah, now I get to see you. That's better. Yep, I think that'll work. That'll work. If you want it, Annabella, you can make yours bigger. Here's my two other examples, just so you get a sense for where they're put on the paper. Up to you. I mean, if you don't want them all the way down, it's fine. We are gonna be putting the flower stem going off the bottom of the page, if that makes a difference to you. Okay? All right, you've got step number one. Step number two is that little slide of a forehead. And I'm going to continue it on. I'm going to go ahead and put the bottom of his snout and that cute little ball nose. So you get to see him all at one time. Nice observation, Molly Jo. Cute, Emma, already. Just that nose gives him so much personality. Cute. So Molly, your nose could be longer. I like the slope. The slope is awesome, but it's going out sideways a little longer. I'm looking at Lucy's. Luce, bring it closer. Yep, looking good. How are you feeling, Sammy? A-okay? Okay. And, oh yeah, good correction. Nice job. And who else did I miss somebody? Emma, did I get yours? Yeah, I got Emma's already. Annabella? Cute. Good. Everyone, awesome. Then he's got a tiny bit of a neck. And then I'm gonna show you his front. He's almost like a little roly-poly. You know, he rolls up in a ball for protection. And I'm gonna go ahead and do this now. I'm also gonna put some little fuzzy, furry marks on his chest. I don't know if you can see that. So first go ahead and make your shape and then give him a little bit of fuzz ball on his chest. The other tip is you do not need to write that hard. In fact, after we finish making the general shapes, we're gonna erase a lot of these marks so that only you can see them. Because with watercolor painting, you really don't want to see the pencils too much. Okay, Mal, yours needs to be rounder at the bottom. Fatter, maybe I should say fatter. Is that a better description? You can notice the difference? I see you shaking your head, that's awesome. Nice, Annabella. Looking good, Lucy. Nice. You make some awesome adjustments. Good listening skills. Okay, everyone looking good. Now his has a shoulder, and this part of his arm, the upper arm, is pretty wide, and it comes in wide in the middle of the body. This arm is actually thinner version than this arm. Look at how fat that arm can be. So I'll go ahead and draw mine in. And he is an itty bitty little hand. His hand's not big at all. And we're gonna put the thumb facing up because he's clenching that flower stem. So we're gonna actually see the thumb and only the knuckles. I'm drawing it out for you. And he does have like a little wrist and an elbow.
Can I please see
show the sample? Sure. There's the sample. So can you see how it comes out? We're gonna put this other line in just a second, but I want you to get the hand line in. So he's got his thumb up and the flower post goes right in the middle. And all you really see are his knuckles. You don't see his full fingers. He does have a little wrist and a bend in his elbow. Cute, Annabella. Okay, that's good for now because we're gonna put in another line and I think that's gonna help you in a second. Nice, good. In fact, I'm gonna go ahead and put in that other line just to help you out. The next line I'm drawing marks the difference between the brown spikes and his white belly. And it's a little bumpy too. But now you can see how the arm fits in to the brown. I think that will be more helpful. Good, nice shoulder, high arm there, Molly Jo. Yeah, looking good. Annabella, Lucy, bring it forward a tiny bit. Yeah, super cute. You can make your lower arm come in a little bit more. You can extend it into the middle of his body.
Mine's like super fat, my hedgehog, so.
You like that?
Or is he fat? I don't,
is he too fat?
Super like fat.
I think they're cute fat, but if you want to make them thinner, you can. You can bring in his belly. My belly's pretty big. If you want to make his belly smaller, you can. Let's see, which one am I? Oh, look at how small this belly is. This belly's much thinner. No right or wrong way to be an artist. You like that? Oh, he is big. Now, the only thing that we got to be aware of in your case, Lucy, is where's the stem gonna go? Is your stem gonna bump into his body?
I don't know. I would have it.
Okay, I'm looking at Emma's. Emma, I have a hard time making out your hand. Maybe you can make those lines a little darker and then we'll erase them. After. Can you just go over them a little darker for me?
Are we drawing the flower?
Not yet. We're still working on the hedgehog. How are y'all feeling about that? Okay. Annabella, you doing okay?
Are we supposed to draw the hands?
Yes, please. And thumb is up, showing the knuckles. How about you, Sam? Let's see what you got. Are you not ready yet? Okay. All right. Next, we're gonna put in a little fuzzy lines for where the hair goes and his ears. His ears are a double C, which we will paint the interior pink in a little bit. Really love your observations, Molly Jo. Way to lift up your head and take a peek. Super cute. Now, Molly, go ahead and extend your ear a little further beyond the hairline, because his ears actually start in the white part of his face.
I made so many lines, it's like...
It's hard to know which one is the one you want.
Yeah. Oh,
good job. Good job. Nice. Super cute. Looking good. Anybody else ready? There is one line you can erase, Molly Jo. This line right here, going across the arm, you can erase that. Okay. How we doing? Anybody ready to show me?
Must terrifying.
Looks great, Emma. Looks really good. Yep, look good, Annabella. Your ear is a tiny bit tiny. No pun intended there. Okay, Sammy, I think this part down here is a little narrow. Why don't you see if you can make that a little wider? And the reason why
I can see all the lines that I erased.
No worries. So the reason why I said to make his snout a little wider is because we got to fit a mouth in there. And while I'm at it, I'm going to draw the eye. Both the eye and the nose had a shine in it. We didn't talk about it when we looked at the slides, but they're round and shiny, so they're gonna have that wet shine. And let me just fill in the nose and I'll show you both the mouth, the eye, and the nose. There we are. There we go. So now you got the whole face. So you need that little smile line, which that's one of the reasons why we want to have a little bit more fatness in there. And I'll show you.
I'm going to get another pencil.
Okay. Oh my goodness, Molly Jo. So cute. He's adorable. Oh yeah, Emma. So well done. Nice. Okay. How about Sammy and Lucy? Lucy, you look
sorry, like- it's taking a long time because this thing I really am not liking.
Yeah? What is it you're not liking?
The belly shape.
Okay. You want me to look at it and give you a tip?
Sure.
Okay. Okay, so maybe you're
thinking- body is huge. I think I'm gonna make it smaller.
Well, here, lift your head for a second. Here's a thought. Are you feeling like the spiky section is too wide? Because maybe you need to bring in the spiky line a little bit. That's what I noticed. I feel like the spiky section is super wide, more than the belly.
Yeah.
So why don't you bring in the spiky line? So that's a more narrow space. Now, for those who are waiting.
Is this a better, like...
Yeah, bring this line in. Bring this line over a little bit. This one, beep, beep. Everybody else, now what I'd like you to do is to slightly erase, especially this side, because if you notice, you won't see any pencil or Sharpie line. We are not gonna have it in here. This is just gonna get painted with the watercolor paint. So we don't wanna see that pencil line. You need to see it because you need to know where the paint's gonna go. And just by erasing, you'll have a little residue left over. So first we're gonna erase that line, and next we're gonna do our little spikes. Is that,
so we are erasing a whole entire hedgehog?
No. Because we still have to go do Sharpie on this part. But just the first letter C that we did, we just want to take that most of the pencil line away. You just need to be
able to... Okay, so like only the back we want to
correct. Do. Thank you. Yes.
Thank you.
Sorry. Yep. And then we're going to put the spikes on. Adorable. Looks good, Annabella. Yep. Looks great. Looks good, Emma. Yep, that's it. Thank you. And next we're going to put the spikes. Now, of course, mine's in Sharpie because I want you to see the line. But normally this would be very light now. And the spikes, you can make... Oh, before we do the spikes, there's one other thing I want to do. He had like this cute little, like, I don't know what you want to call it, mohawk on the top of his head. And the hairs go in opposite directions, kind of like if you're putting whiskers on, they don't all go the same way. Let me show you a finished one. You can give it a little curl if you want, like they're coming up over his forehead. So we just need a couple little hairs, mohawk hairs on the top.
Sorry.
And Emma, it's going to start actually at his forehead. It starts kind of at the hairline. You can also give him some little thin strokes in here. Deet, 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 deet.
Look at.
I'm looking, Molly Jo. Turn your paper. Okay, so yours are a little low. Yours need to go, they start right at the brown section, not at the white section. No, but you know what I would do? I would not erase what you have. I would just extend them to start in the brown. Just have them go into the brown a little bit. Don't even worry about where they are right now.
Whoa.
Yeah.
My watercolor paint turned into like slime.
Oh, I know. How did that happen? Did you add some water?
No, I didn't. I mean, it's watercolor, so probably I did, but like, look at this. This is.
I hope you have a napkin with you.
Like, it was really weird.
Gross. Sammy, how are you? Okay, you want me to show me? Can I see yours? I feel like I haven't seen yours in a while.
Me?
Sammy's. She's not ready to share. Okay, everybody else ready? So then you're gonna do your little spikes. I'll show you on here. Some of them come up, some of them come down. Most of the time they actually come down, but there's not always order. And they're, what would you call that? Maybe like a think banana, little tiny banana spikes. They're, or upside down V's. Some of them are straight lines, some of them are thin. And they kind of go to his elbow. So his arm will have a couple spikes. But you want to make sure they cross that pencil line that we erased. So I'll go ahead and do some of mine.
Are we doing this with Sharpie or pencil?
Oh, let's do it in pencil first. That way, if you don't like what you did, you can erase it. Because it kind of takes a little nap. Practice where you're going to put them. So go ahead and do it in pencil first. That way, if you're not happy, you can always erase it.
Oh, great.
What's up, Lucy? What's so great?
I got it stuck on my table.
Oh, yeah. Sammy's looking good. You got it stuck on your table? Well, it's a watercolor, right? So it should come right off. Is that what you're talking about? Okay, Sammy, you ready for your little wrist? Don't forget to put your wrist in. You want to look at my hand?
One second. Let me go get a claw.
Samantha, look at his little hand.
Whenever an animal that's holding something, I always do the hands last.
Okay, if you're comfortable with that, that's fine. I'm going to keep putting my little spiky guys on. You guys can do the same. Ah, Molly Jo. Lower it a little bit. Lower. Yep, go. There's one section right near his back that needs a little more. And see if you can make the points a little curvy. Okay?
Yep.
Good to hear. How's everybody liking their spikes?
Are they just corners?
They're kind of curvy corners, curvy bees.
Like this?
Yeah. Super cute. Super cute.
Also, I finally learned how to draw hands.
Hi.
I finally learned how to draw hands.
Oh, nice hands. Yeah, and how you got the thumb separated from the other fingers. Good. Is that Dominic?
Hi, Dominic.
Hi, Dominic. How are you?
Back from karate class.
His first karate class.
You had karate class today? How fun is that? Awesome. Yeah. Was it good?
Yeah.
Yeah, that must have been fun.
Yeah.
Nice. Oh, Annabella. Super cute. Super cute. Looks good. Don't forget to put his facial features in, his eye and his mouth. And when you're ready, when you're done with all that pencil, you are ready to put everything in Sharpie, remembering that we are not going to put Sharpie along his back. But everything else gets, those lines get covered in with Sharpie. So if you've done everything else, you can go ahead and do that.
Can I fix his eye? Because like it's really small and like it's really bugging me.
I love it. You're the artist. Absolutely fix it if you don't like it. Yeah, definitely. You have enough space in there to put a little shine mark, Molly Jo?
Oh, shine?
Yeah, you know, like just a little tiny shine. And in his nose, too, there's a little shine. You can do it in Sharpie if you want. You can just go ahead and fill it in Sharpie. Let's see. I'll show you this guy. I'll keep him up. You can see the little shine marks.
One time, Scout ate a whole batch of dough, and one time Scout ate a whole batch of dough.
He ate a whole batch of dough. Did he have a tummy ache afterwards?
Yeah. Also, he has once eaten two big bags of Skittles.
Good, Emma. Looks good.
Alexa.
Hi, Renee. Emma, can I check out his arm? Check out his arm. One second. Be a little closer. Yep, so my suggestion is you can bring in his elbow line past the spiky point. Just bring it in a little bit, okay? So how was karate class?
It's actually jujitsu.
Ooh. It was good?
Thumbs up.
Giving it a thumbs up.
Hi, Julie.
Cool.
Hi, Luz.
Lucy.
Hi, Emma.
Your cousin's calling you. Renee, did you get your hair done?
Yeah, it's much lighter.
I love it.
Thanks.
It's really pretty. Yeah,
it's very pretty. To be a blonde like my sister and Lucy. Mommy. I think those jeans.
It's very pretty. Looks good. Oh, nice, Annabella. Okay, you're ready. If you got all those pencil marks, you can go ahead and do everything in Sharpie before we move on to the flower. Oh, so I got some music going. All right.
Sharpie go.
While you guys do your Sharpie action, I'll tell you a couple fun facts about the hedgehog. It is called a hedgehog for two reasons. It lives under hedges, bushes, and shrubs. And it's called a hog because it does make a little snorting sound like a hog. So hedge and hog.
I'll be back.
Oh, Sammy, it looks good. Nice. At one point, you can go ahead and fill it in with Sharpie. Oh, Sammy, did you hear that one point about erasing the line on his back? I can only see your hair. I can't see your face. Yeah, so now go, before you put your Sharpie line in, go ahead and erase the pencil line on it. Oh, that big gigantic C, the very first line we did. Erase that pencil line.
Mrs. Kenny.
Yes, Emma.
I have a question. So with your Sharpie, do you also use Sharpie for your like spikes?
Yes.
Okay.
And they don't have to be exact. So if your Sharpie kind of misses the pencil line, because it's all just kind of bushy anyway, so it doesn't have to be exact. And of course, we'll erase all the pencil lines after you get your Sharpie. So, Lucy looks super cute. Everybody look at Lucy. Oh yeah, look at Molly Joe's. Look at how different they are. Oh my gosh, so cute. Awesome. Awesome. So we got the hedge and the hog. But at one point, hedgehogs were called sea urchins. So they had another name at one point, which is why he was called an urchin. But then in the ocean, there's the sea urchin, who's also spiky. He's known as the gardener's friend because he loves beetles and insects and caterpillars and all the things that might eat a gardener's vegetables or flowers. So he's a friendly guy in the garden. Gardeners love little hedgehogs to help them out eat all the insects in the garden. And there are over 15 different species of hedgehogs in the world. And they have anywhere from 2,000 to 5,000 spikes on them. But we are not drawing that many.
Did you know when polar bears are born, they're the size of a butterfly?
A size of a what? A butterfly?
A butter stick.
Really? No, I didn't. I knew they were tiny, but I didn't know they were that tiny. That's small, given how big that animal is. And I think they're born blind. I think they can't see, and they have very little, no fur. Love the polar bear. And my last fun fact is those little tiny legs that we saw can actually walk up to 2 miles away, which for a critter that small is pretty darn far.
We're actually learning about animals today, and we got to use the iPads in school for the first time this year.
That's fun. So what did you do with the, iPad?
We went to this app called like San Diego Zoo, and we had to learn about polar bears.
Oh.
Someone stole my black Sharpie and my black marker that I use.
Who would steal your Sharpie?
What? I have no idea. I might have just lost it.
Oh, it must be a leprechaun a little bit late. Okay, how's those marks going? Lucy? Oh, Lucy did hers already. I saw hers. That's right.
Can I do the flower?
Not yet.
Did you see mine?
Not yet. That looks good, Emma. Yep, you do not need to put that.
I need a new paint so bad.
Do you?
These are my paints. Can you see them?
They're looking, you're frozen right now. Oh, they. Oh yeah, those are well-loved paints. Very well used.
Ugh, they're so gross. They're from last, they're from your last spring session.
Oh my goodness.
And I've used them so many times.
Maybe you should make that a goal of yours for the next spring session, because we have at least 2, maybe 3 watercolor paintings we're going to be doing.
The yellow is literally orange.
Oh, yeah. Yellow gets dirty.
I mean, no. There is no orange.
That's all gone, huh?
The orange turned into blue.
Uh-oh.
See, this was orange.
Oh, my goodness.
It turned into blue.
Oh, my goodness. That's crazy.
And then look at this thing.
Oh, they popped out of the case, huh?
Yeah, they do. They're just in plastic, so.
You can still use the lid for mixing. You got a nice surface for mixing there.
Yep, that's what you use it for.
Or if you want, you can always mix in a lid.
This is what someone is like a scout when Red Scout does something wrong.
Is that a dog?
Yes. Like when Scout does something like really bad, they grab on her collar and like just like grab her, like put her out.
Oh, fun. Fun.
Also Scout, like after she drinks water, like it goes down there. And it's really cute.
Oh, she's drooling? Yeah. Okay, so if you've got your Sharpie marks on and you're happy with them, don't forget to erase. Erase all the pencil lines because we won't need them. And then we're going to get ready for our flower. Oh, yeah, Isabella. Super duper cute.
This is Linda.
Yes.
I just spilled water and I heard my cat jump off the couch. And of course, he's drinking it.
He must be thirsty. That's pretty funny. Do you need to wipe up your water?
Yeah.
Hopefully it's not near your computer. Wipe up anything near your computer first.
I think I know how to draw the flower already.
What do you do? You're so smart. So what I want you to notice, I'll show you the example. Let's see, which one am I going to show you? I'll show you this guy. I want you to think about the spacing of the flower. Are we all ready to start thinking about the flower? All right, everybody lift your heads up. Where'd you go, Molly Jo? There she is. Okay, spacing and layout. You got the second half of the page to fill in. A fairly large flower. The button or the black eye needs to have enough space between the nose so you can fit in a medium-sized long petal. But you also need enough room so it's not off the page. So it's the button is kind of smack in the middle and it's tilted on a diagonal. So it's that rainbow arc, little bumpy because it has a texture. And going to the side. Annabella, yours can be bigger. Probably two to three times more that size. It's pretty big. Molly Jo, much further that way. Even further away, Molly Jo. And it can be bigger. So it can be bigger and move it over to this side. Okay. Lucy, you want me to see? He's jumping ahead. Your flower's a little small. Look at all that space you got to fill.
Like this?
Yeah, good job. If you want, Lucy, if you wanted to leave what you have, you could just put a second flower on yours if you want. Oh, yeah, Annabella, you're on it. Good job. Yep, you too, Emma. Nice. Timmy, you make sure to get all the water away from your computer.
Got it all gone.
Good, because we don't want any water near the electronics. Okay, so we got that button shape first. Then let me show you what we're gonna do. Remember how we talked about the petals being two layers and some are on top of the others? So we're gonna need to leave a space. You're gonna make a petal, then a space, a petal, then a space. And I will show you a couple so you get the right idea. And you can give them a little curve if you want because gravity pulls them down. So can you see how they are? The tip is actually going in front of that bottom line on the button. And there is a space between each one. Because we're going to put a partially covered petal behind those. Does that make sense to everybody? So you're starting inside the button, little loop, and you're leaving a space between them.
Yes.
Nice. Yes, very nice. Cool, Emma. Yep.
out.
And the ones on the side are a little bit more curved, almost like a banana. They're drooping off the side. Gravity's pulling.
It looks like a jellyfish.
Oh, yeah. It kind of looks like a jellyfish. Yeah.
No, the flower.
Definitely not the hedgehog.
Yeah.
Molly Jo, this petal you have here, make this one curvy. Right now it's pretty straight.
See? I'm done.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
it's got a curve. Thanks, Emma. Good job. All right, Luce, doing good. And then we're going to put the other petals in between. You only see the tips, the rounded tips, I should say. They're kind of tucking underneath each of them. Ta-da! And maybe some are a little shorter than others. They're definitely not perfect. Mother Nature is usually not perfect. Anybody got a peek of that?
Sorry, I'm trying to get something off that got wet.
Okay. Oh, it's just water though, right?
Dang it.
Should I use this? It's just garbage, I think.
Please use it.
Nice, Emma. Wow, nice. And then you can decide where you want that stem to go. It's best to start the stem kind of between two leaves as opposed to...
By the way, if you want like a brown hair color, then use yellow, brown, and white.
I'll show you what I mean by that.
I don't want to fix the hair. That's you.
Are you ready, Emma? Look how thin the stem is, Emma. And it's coming between two petals. Don't have it come from one petal. Pick a space where it's coming between two. And it's very thin, as if it's nestled inside his little tiny paw. Your stem is nice and thin, Lucy. It fits inside his hand.
I haven't done the flower yet because I had to clean up the water.
No worries.
And now I'm still erasing stuff.
Okay. What's your channel name for your video, your YouTube channel?
Just me. Just Linda Kenny.
I
don't know if you could find me or not. I haven't done it.
Does Mrs. Kenny look at?
Oh, Molly Jo, super duper cute. I love it. And you have the stem coming all the way off to the bottom of the page? And the stem is a little curved because the flower's heavy, so it's getting bent a little bit. Okay, we'll see people drawn, so we'll wait a second. Nice. Okay, so Emma, your stem can be moved over a little bit behind the hand. Maybe keep it a little bit more of a bend.
Can we do
it? Every time I make flowers, it always looks like it's like fake.
Fake? They don't look real enough?
Like whenever I draw flowers, I always like kind of sketch, like, here, I'll show you in a second.
Okay. Guess what? In our spring session, we are going to learn how to draw four different kinds of flowers. So that'll be useful for you. That looks good, Annabella. Then you can give it. Remember we saw in the real flowers how they had like little stripes inside, little bends. So let me draw mine. You can decide where you're going to put them.
How I made my flower is it looks like this is the petal, right? Not the petal, the leaf right here. And it looks like he's smelling the flower.
Oh, wait. That's a good little interpretation. Nice.
Where is it?
Oh, here. So Then you can give it, oh, good, Emma. Nice change there. Nice. Then you can give them some little stripey sections. And if you use a very skinny paintbrush, you can paint those sections inside orange. Or just gives it a little bit more texture and also helps with that 3D effect. Let me see, Molly. Yeah, you're on the right track. Okay, just one more minute there, and then we're going to do our leaf. One very large leaf that is folded in half.
What is it this time, Dad? You seem angry.
What time is it?
It is 4:33. We've got just under half an hour left. Okay. Oh, we got enough people ready to start their leaf?
Uh-huh.
I see three yeses at least. Here we go. The leaf stem comes up on a diagonal. You got all this, you should have a lot of space over here so you can fill it with a pretty big leaf. The leaf comes off the stem like a tube, like a little straw. It's a little rounded. We want the viewer to know it's round, comes off the stem like a straw would, and it comes diagonal. And it's almost like a teardrop. It's bendy this way, and then when you bring it back, it's got these little these little breaks in it. That is one side of this folded leaf. It's a very large leaf. Nice observing, Molly Jo.
Mrs. Linda, want to know why Thursdays are always stressful for me?
Say that one more time.
You want to know why Thursdays are always stressful for me?
No, why are they stressful for you?
Because everyone has to do homework. And then I go to school from 12 to 2:25, and then after that I have to get ready for art, and then I join art, then after art I have to rush and get taekwondo clothes on, and then go to taekwondo, and then come back and eat dinner and feed the cat.
Good thing the spring session you'll be joining us on Wednesdays. That's going to give your schedule a little bit more flexibility.
Yeah, but I probably won't be able to see Annabella.
Well, wait, you'll have to see each other.
I'm going to be joining on Wednesdays.
No, not you, just Sammy.
Linda.
Yes.
Because I've already,
accidentally put the leaf on the wrong side, so now I have to do it all over again.
Well, does it look good? Maybe you have two leaves.
No, it actually does not.
Okay. Yeah, so nice, Annabella. So, you can leave yours like that, because it looks beautiful. Let me show you how the second fold goes. You can decide. Oops, I didn't quite do that as good as I'd like. Maybe like that. Yeah, I'll show you this one. Then you can put a second one underneath that shows you where the fold is. Does that make sense? You're gonna put one right underneath. And it's kind of got a little jaggediness to it also. Beautiful, Molly Jo. Wow. And then you can put these little veins in. So he's got like a spine, and then he's got these little flowy veins that come in.
Yes. He is not here right now, but we were looking for his medicine for poison oak, a lotion. He got the prednisone.
Annabella.
He did not get the lotion.
Annabella. Michelle. Thanks. Thank you. No worries. It's all good. Emma, nailing it again. Good job. Way to nail it. Okay. Now you're ready for a Sharpie. Anywhere you like. And you can put, I'll do it on this one. You can put some little like bumpy Sharpie marks inside your button too, because he's 3D. He had those little, I don't know what you want to call them, little knobs.
Is this good?
I love it. What do you think?
I don't know.
I like it.
Does it look like the picture?
Yeah, I'll bring it back. You happen to have a lot more sharp little points, but you know, that's just a style. I don't think I'd change it. You go ahead and put this other one down below, Lucy. Leave some space in there and put the other half of the petal.
Nice. Oh, let me just.
Are we going to have time to color this one card?
Yeah, we still have 22 minutes. So the first thing you're going to do is do the Sharpie part though, okay? So we'll do Sharpie for about 5 minutes and then we'll be ready for painting. Yes, we will. There's not a lot of colors in this composition. She's already started hers. Sammy, I feel like you need something going on. You need a leaf or something in that empty space. You need something else.
Are we doing the Sharpie right now?
Yes, you are. Thank you for asking. Yesterday, somebody had an empty space and they were very clever. They decided to put in the red mushroom with the white polka dots in the empty space. It looked awesome. Since you're experts in red mushrooms. So that's an idea if you're looking to fill some space.
My whole paper is like already filled.
Yeah, so is mine. So I'm not.
I have a ginormous leaf.
Yeah, it's supposed to be pretty big. It's a pretty big leaf on the Black Eyed Susan.
Who thought of that? And like which group?
Who thought of it? Let's see who did. That was Iris. Do you know Iris? Iris goes to Morello Park. So Annabella and Sammy know Iris.
That was a good idea, though.
Wasn't it? Yeah, I agree. Very creative.
Now it's time to draw the leaf, and then I'll be doing the Sharpie.
Nice. And then when you get all those Sharpie lines in, oh, I was going to show you the little marks I put in my inside my button. That helps, Sammy. You put the ground in. That's good. Still feel like you need something, a big leaf or something next to that flower. It's very empty. And here's my little I don't know what you call it. These little bumps I put in inside the black eye of the Black-Eyed Susan.
Why is it called the Black-Eyed Susan?
Isn't that funny? That's what they call it. So I bet you somebody knew somebody named Susan and they're like, hey, that button looks like an eye. Let's call it a Black-Eyed Susan. I don't know how many times plants get their names. I have no idea.
It's really weird. There's some really weird ones out there.
There are some weird ones out there.
All right, can I start painting?
Yes, let me give you tips on painting. We're going to start with the brown hedgehog. The hedgehog is very light brown. How are we going to create light brown? Who's going to tell me how with watercolors do you get a light brown? Yes, Lucy.
You mix brown with more water than usual.
Yes. So in this case, it's because brown is a dark color. It's like you're going to paint with dirty color. Looks good, Emma. It's like you're going to paint with dirty water. You need just a skitch of brown. That's better. Still looking for something next to that flower, Sammy. So it's mostly water. So just a little dip in the brown and lots of water. It's really like painting with dirty water. Does everyone have brown? Because the little painting kit that I have has a more of a reddish brown. If you do not have brown, the way you create brown is orange plus a skitch of black. Just a tiny bit of black makes.
Is it Linda?
Yes, Sammy.
What's your favorite song, Justin Bieber?
What's my favorite what?
Song from Justin Bieber.
Oh my god. Yeah, that's a hard question. I don't know. I'd have to search his songs again and then pick one. I don't know off the top of my head. What's your favorite Justin Bieber song?
Watermelon Sugar.
Ooh, I'll have to look that one up. I don't know if I
know that. Wait, I thought that was from Harry Styles.
Hey, Sam. Yeah?
I don't know. I don't know who did that one.
Didn't I say Harry
Styles?
Yeah. Watermelon Sugar is from Harry Styles.
Okay, there you go. Take it from the expert. Oh, don't forget when we're painting. Dip your brush in there. Get it super wet. Super wet. And if you've got this paint set.
I'm still drawing.
Okay.
Mine, like, is really dark on accident. So I'm just going to do what I did last time, like, spray.
Don't rub too hard with your paintbrush, Molly Jo, because it will rip the paper, okay? So just be gentle with the paintbrush. The other thing you can do if your color gets dark is you take your towel or your paper towel, Molly. Watch it, Molly Jo. And just take your paper towel and sop up some of that color this way. Okay. You can lift up some of that color.
Where's my green?
You know you can make green, Lucy, but up maybe not because you don't have any yellow. What two colors make green?
Blue and yellow.
Blue and yellow.
I think orange.
Orange is not going to make green. If you mix orange with blue, you're going to get brown. What else do they want to show you? Remember, we're leaving the face and the belly clear. Look at that. Sammy just popped off. She didn't even say goodbye. No, we are not painting the face. And eventually we'll add a little cheek and a little pink in the ear. Oh my goodness. Oh, I love it, Annabelle. Oh, it looks great. Fun. Cute. Way to fill in the composition.
Wow, I have to go flower.
So just so I have a sense, who's painting now? What? Emma, have you started painting?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Lucy's trying to mix color, I think is what I hear from her mic. Is that true?
No, I'm trying to get all the green out.
Okay. One tip, Molly Jo.
Yeah.
When you're painting, go ahead and, everybody can look at this tip. When you're painting, scoot your hand closer. Scoot your hand closer to the brush. You'll get a lot more control if you have your hand in the metal or closer to the paint brush itself. If you hold it up here, Molly, you watching? If you hold it way up here, you don't get as much control. You're more likely to make a mistake if you hold it at the tip. So hold it just like you hold a pencil, hold it closer to the middle or the point.
No, it's really funny.
What?
My thing right now, my whatever it's called, my green.
Yes.
When you look at it, it's green, but then it's also blue at the same time.
Ah, that means it's got more blue in it than it has yellow.
Yellow.
But I actually really like the color.
Okay. Now I have to do the yellow. You know, have right. Yellow. The conflict is that somebody.
Whoa! Oh my! Okay.
So when you're putting the paint on the watercolor paper, if you find it is not spreading, it means you don't have enough water. You can do wet on wet technique. You can paint the whole section with water first. And then put your color on and it'll spread a lot easier and less likely to get absorbed into the paper. So more water is gonna let you spread it easier. We are also putting darker color near the edges because it's gonna make it look more 3D if you put the darker color at the edges, on the bottom, at his back, and lighter color in the middle.
so happy. Why? I just found another one of these because this somebody puts all the red inside the yellow, a lot of the red inside the yellow, so I couldn't use it, but now I just found another one, so I can use this one.
I love you. Where are you going?
Wait, you got a second set, huh?
And I also see like a third set.
Wait, no, I can't make yellow when I don't have any. Wait, I have an idea. I'll be right back.
Nope, you cannot make yellow. Yellow is a primary color, so you cannot make yellow.
You have to have yellow. That's what you have to have.
She used up all her yellow, so she doesn't have any more.
Oh, that's bad.
Ha! Makes sense?
Yeah.
Good.
I wish I just could just go to Lucy's house right now and just give her yellow and look like,
bye. Oh, wouldn't that be nice, sharing with your cousin?
Yes.
That would be awesome.
Remember when I used to go to Lucy's house? And
yes, I remember that summer you did that. That was fun.
Yeah.
And then she came to your house too.
It's like the Susan Eye or whatever it's called.
Black Eye Susan? Uh-huh.
Brown or black?
That is an awesome question. It is actually a dark brown. So start with a tiny bit of black. And then
I'll be right back, okay? I do in the bathroom.
Okay.
Wait, so I have to do black and then brown.
But only a little bit of black, because black is the strongest color. So only a tiny bit. Hold your brush closer to the tip, Molly Jo. Scooch it up. That's it.
Okay. Now I did that, but now I have to do.
So for those people who want to make their artwork even better, like I know Emma always likes to make her artwork even better, you would have it lighter in here. Annabella, same thing. It would be lighter in here and darker on the edges. So right now, if it's all the same and it's flat, you can take a wet, clean paintbrush and just swoop up, and you'll probably pull up some of that color. Just just plain water right in the middle here and swoop up some of that brown, and then wipe it on your paper towel and you'll pick up some of that color and it'll be lighter in here. And that'll help us start to give the illusion that it's three-dimensional, because we know this guy is super round. He's a roly-poly.
I finished 10 minutes early.
You are fast. Let me see what you got. Can you lift it or is it runny? If it's super wet, don't lift it up.
That's it.
Awesome. So Molly, now we get to paint the petals. The petals are yellow and orange. It looks white. Right now it looks white.
Really light yellow, because like my yellow on the other one is like really light.
Is it? Okay. Also, we're gonna paint in his cute little ears. Pink.
I did that too.
Did you give him a light cheek mark? You can't even see in the monitor. He has a super light pink cheek mark.
Well, I will do it right now.
Let me see if I have it on this one. This one's a little brighter. This one, it looks like he has makeup on. It's too bright in my opinion. Looks like he's got some rouge.
No. I did.
I like the light pink cheeks. So don't forget that.
I did it way too bright.
Okay, take the paper towel and wipe it off.
That's what I did with my Susan thing, because I put way too much water.
When it's still not light enough, so we're using water as my second solution.
I like it. Yep, dirty red water would make a beautiful pink.
Yeah, she finally got on
to it. How are the bigger girls doing? You know,
okay?
Yeah. Bigger. Yeah. Bigger than you even. Maybe. Annabella, how are you doing? Doing okay?
I'm going to go put this outside to dry. Be right back.
Okay. You might want to put a rock on top of it so it doesn't blow away.
Okay, I'll do that.
Ah, yes, working on the background. And then another tip, if you want to make it even better, is you could paint in the spikes darker. Like just the paint, this the little area in the spike can be a little darker, and that'll give it more of a 3D element also. Don't have to do it, just a suggestion. And I'm gonna do it on mine, but I'm not gonna do it on all of them. Hello again. Yeah. Yeah. Going on in my pink ears. Little pinky. Lots and lots of water.
I don't know what to do now.
Where are you?
I'm at my house, and I finished way early.
You did. You were a good concentrator today.
Come here, Scout.
I got it. Oops, we missed Emma. I bet you Emma's camera died. Somehow she's missing.
Oh yeah.
Go get them off.
I just looked at all the people on the Zoom. I'm like, oh my god.
Here it is.
Oh, it's beautiful. You know what you could do? You know what you could do, Lucy? Is you could just cut your paper smaller. You know, we have
the extra probably part. Should.
Yeah, just trim off that extra part.
But then I can use the other half for something else, right?
There you go. It's this watercolor paper is really good. Yeah,
I love mixing colors, and before you told me to like do it on the edge of the watercolor thing, I was just doing it in the little tablet thingies. So I have black, pink, orange, green, blue, and then purple, and then I have brown. Forgot what it was called for a second.
You did a lot of mixing then, huh?
Yeah, I need really new paints for this.
Yes, I think that's a good idea. If you want, I can send the link to your mom of the ones that I like. I have my own personal favorites. So I'm adding just a tiny bit of orange on my petals. And it was so concentrated that now I'm going to hop, hop, hop with a paper towel because it was a little too concentrated. And I'm kind of making my petals a gold color.
Really?
Yeah. So it's mostly
your paint palette.
Mostly yellow and a tiny bit of orange gives you gold. And I'm trying to put the gold in those skinny streaks that I added to my petals.
I think I made the little pink spot a little bit like darkened. Yeah. Anyways, look at this. I saw this a couple like a year ago.
Get your paper towel and hop it on the pink and take it off. I love that mini easel. Isn't that cute?
And it's just a little mini easel.
Perfect.
And I don't actually really use it. I was going to use it for my dolls, but I ended up never using it for my dolls, so.
Well, maybe.
I'm actually going to use it in real life because that's what it's used for.
Maybe we'll have to have a mini painting project because I have mini canvases. So we could.
Yeah, I have like these. I already painted on them, though.
Oh, those are nice, yeah. I have even smaller ones than those. Maybe after summer camp if we have.
Oh my! Whoa, those are huge.
Oh yeah, does it stand up?
Yeah, it does.
Cool.
It actually works, but it's pretty big
right now because everyone just left to go outside.
In your family?
Well, Daddy is in the backyard, which is the door is open, but everyone else, except for me, they're soft.
Well, it's not somebody's home.
Yeah.
I also made this one.
What I drew. I drew everyone on Zoom.
Oh, that's fun. I didn't see yours, Lucy. What did you do?
I did this. I made this. It's like
a rainbow?
Yeah, it's like kind of rainbowy. I know the red is like disappearing.
Nice. So now I think everybody's back to school to some degree. Is everybody having art?
My mom was painting with me.
Uh-huh.
And there's paint on her paintbrush. And she was painting with the color red. And then she put it into this cup, and then my
now you're painting
got, like red. Right here.
You know, actually, it looks pretty good. This is some dimension. I didn't know your mom was painting with us. She kept that so quiet. Well, you have to tell your mom to share what she painted so we can see it. We need a photograph. We need a photograph of yours, Michelle. You have to send me a picture of what you're painting.
I got creative with the Morello pickup sign.
Oh, you have this here,
and I walked in to put it on my car.
That's awesome. That's so fun. So fun.
So it's my sign when I pick her up from school.
Nice. I love it. You can put that
good
at your
to see you.
I love it. Super cute. Oh, you're outside, Molly Jo. Look at that. Oh, Scout likes your Minnie Mouse. Oh no, watch out.
That's going to Disneyland.
Oh, no, watch out.
I'm gonna clean up my desk a little because how messy it is.
Okay. Oh, it's
5 p.m. Okay, I just noticed the time. Hard to believe, but it's already 5 o'clock. Does everybody feel great. Good about where they're at? Everyone feel good?
Yep. I just need it.
Thumbs up. Annabella, you're feeling good about what you're doing?
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, looks great. Looks great. Okay, make sure you send me pictures.
Got it.
Everybody, happy Easter, happy spring break.
Bye. Bye. Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye.
Whoops, wait. I can't leave. Bye.
Bye.